Marine plankton are all the small microscopic organisms that float freely in the oceans. They vary up to a billion times in body mass and range, from viruses to bacteria, to both unicellular and multicellular plankton. This is Thomas Kiørboe, professor at the Center for Ocean Life at the Technical University of Denmark.
The plankton is important because despite their small size, they play a fundamental role in regulating the carbon budget of our planet and therefore in regulating our climate. And at the same time, they're also the basis for the production of marine living resources like fish and shellfish that play a major role in feeding a human population. So that's the importance of the plankton. That's the fundament of all higher life in the ocean and play this role in the carbon budget.
Using quantitative methods, Thomas and his team are trying to get a better understanding of plankton's role in regulating the carbon budget of the oceans.
Who eats who and how do they acquire resources? Because that's the way that carbon is processed in the ocean. The phytoplankton assimilate the carbon dioxide and the phytoplankton is then eaten by either bacteria or zooplankton, and that way the carbon is transported in the ecosystem. A small fraction of that carbon will eventually be sequestered, that is, removed from the atmosphere, and that's due to the biological processes. And so therefore we try to understand the fundamentals and the physical mechanisms behind that account for the interaction between the organisms. That way we can build models of ecosystems that have much higher predictive power, at least in principle, than models that are based on heuristic relationships, correlations, observations.
The composition of plankton in the oceans are changing due to global warming. All living organisms below the surface are in general moving towards the poles and away from the equator in order to remain in the temperatures they are used to.
The ability of the zooplankton to remove carbon dioxide from the atmosphere has changed in the North Atlantic. The ability to remove carbon dioxide has increased during the past 50 years, while in the southeastern and main part of the North Atlantic, it has decreased. So we can already see major impacts of global warming on functions of marine ecosystems. The fish fauna near Equator has become less diverse. There are fewer species of fish there, where we have all the poor countries that depend so much on artisanal fisheries in their local economy. So that's already a problem in these areas of the ocean, and that is due to global warming.
There are two main reasons behind this change in the oceans. The first one is that when temperatures are changing, so is the distribution of zooplankton.
But also with changing temperatures, the size distribution of zooplankton changes. The warmer the water, the smaller the zooplankton. And smaller zooplankton has a lower ability to remove carbon dioxide from the atmosphere than larger zooplankton.